As a Mexican-American high school teacher and native of California, I moved to the Sonoran Desert in the summer of 2010, a time when anti-immigration laws like SB 1070 and the ban of ethnic studies in public schools made Arizona a highly controversial place to live. Despite these circumstances, the Sonoran Desert and programs like Linking Hispanic Heritage through Archaeology helped me realize how connected I am to these lands. As a child of immigrants from Jalisco, Mexico, the Sonoran Desert reminded me of my grandfathers, who were hardworking farmers and cattle growers that paid close attention to the natural resources in our environment. Furthermore, the maíz, tortillas, and beans and calabacitas my abuelita cooked were the same foods that made up the diet of the Sonoran ancestral people of the Southwest thousands of years ago. Nonetheless, the grinding of the corn on the metate and the ollas used to cook traditional foods made me value the rich cultural and sustainable practices of my abuelitas. Today, I have a better understanding of the important history that makes up the Sonoran Desert. Visiting the national parks in Arizona, experiencing the outdoors, and excavating the archaeological sites have made me a better educator. From my experience in the Linking Hispanic Heritage through Archaeology program, I plan to design deeper classroom lessons on the Hohokam and the Sinagua, with field trips to some of the national monuments like Casa Grande and Tusigu to give students a critical understanding of the ancestral Sonoran Desert people. Most importantly, the shared outdoor experiences with our youth on the hiking trails, the overnight camping, the gardens, and the restoration work at the sites we visited created a bonding and unforgettable experience. The opportunity to work with these youth and organizers was an honor and privilege. Thank you. Tlazo Kamatli. Ometeo.